Hello everyone, this is Hoda Genci and today I'm going to talk about how we can create a product in Dynamo in Revit. A product could be anything. It could be a furniture, it could be a bench, a lamp, or it could be part of the building components, for instance, shading. So if you want to work on product design in future, this lesson could be helpful to you. So I'm going to work on this bench that you see here. It's pretty simple. I didn't make it so complicated yet. So let's go to Revit. I'm going to open a new file, maybe a metric template. I want to change the units, type UN. I want to go with meters and three decimal places. If you go with millimeters or centimeters, then you need to be very careful with your numbers in Dynamo so they're gonna match with your Revit file. I prefer to go with meters. I'm gonna open Dynamo. A new file. So if you want to get something like this, first we need to create one of these curves, and then we can just make a list, a sequence, to copy that several times in one direction. Then we can thicken the surface, and then we can thicken that surface again, to have a volume like this. Okay. So how about we start by creating some points? I'm gonna go with point by coordinates. I want to create the four corners of the bench, so I'll go with four points, Control C, Control V, and then I'll take care of the dimensions. So if the first point is on 0, 0, maybe the second one I want it to move on that direction by 1 meter. I think that's the Y direction. I'm going to bring a code block, put 1, assign it to Y. That's correct. Okay, now I need two more points, so I need to assign Y to one other point, and the Z of the two points should be a little bit more than 0, and 1 is too much, so I'm gonna bring a new code block by double-clicking on the canvas. I wanna go with about 50 centimeters or 0.5 meters, and I'm gonna assign it to the Z of the other two points. Okay, this seems good. Now you might think how that curve is created. I'll show you how. If we go to Geometry, Curves, I want to go to NURBS Curve, and I'm interested in one of the by points curves. I can go with this one, for instance. You see, I have points here, but I have 4 points over there. Right? The easiest way to combine these points and assign them to points as one single parameter is just using list. You already know about it from the other playlist, Parametric Design in Dynamo. I'm gonna suggest that if you have not watched that playlist, maybe you can watch that one first and then come to this one. I need four items to connect the points to the items of the list. If I pin this here, you see that now all the four points are in one list. I can assign this to the points and it's going to create a curve. Okay, so you see it's in that direction. It means that the points are not in correct order. So if this is my 0, this point is 0, 1, 0. How about I change this and this point. Not again. Okay, this goes there. Maybe this should go there. We are getting close. This should go there and this should go there. Okay, so the order of the points actually matter in how the curve is created, right? So this is the curve. Those are the four corners. You can even group them. Create a group. This is gonna be basic curve points. So this is the points which is creating our first curve, and we can go with different values later. Now you might think, what's that degree? That degree tells us how much curved this curve is going to be. For instance, if I put 0 and assign it to the degrees, it's not going to create any curve at all. If I go with 1, it's going to give us only straight lines because there is no amount of curve. If I go with 2, it's going to make it a bit more curved. And then if I continue, for instance, if I go with 3, it's going to be even more curved. As I want to have a relatively flat surface at the top, maybe I would go with just 2. This seems good. Now that I have the curve, I can translate it or move it in that direction to have a number of curves to be close to, like this one. How about I use move, or move is the same as translate in Dynamo. I'm gonna go with translate. The geometry is a curve. It's gonna move in that direction. I guess that's our x direction because this is y, that should be x. If I assign, for instance, 1 meter to our x, it's gonna move it by 1 meter. If I want to get close to this one, it's more than just one curve, right? You remember, if we go with like a sequence, we can go with at least more than one. If I assign this sequence to the x translation, it's going to create 10 elements because the amount is on 10 by default, and each of them is 1 meter away. But I don't want them to be 1 meter away. I want them to be away by about 10 centimeters. And I need more of them. For instance, I can go with 30. And this seems better now. You can do a lot of things with curves. They are very handful items. Now I just want to thicken the curve. So if you type thicken, we have different options to thicken the curve. For instance, this one. I'm gonna thicken these curves by about maybe 5 centimeters, which is 0.05, going to thickness. And it's asking about the normal. Nor is a short for normal, and we know we are going in that direction. And if this is the curve, the normal would be the x. I'm gonna type x, and I need the x-axis to the normal. There we go. Okay, now we have this curve. It's still not a surface, it's just a curve, so I need to patch the surface, so it's going to create an actual surface in between the curve. So this goes there. Now you see, if I turn this off, and maybe I can also turn this off, you're gonna only see the surface, right? We can keep going. We can thicken the surface this time. So thicken surface. Maybe again by about 5 centimeters, which is 0.05, and this is what we get. So this is a very straightforward, very simple bench. You can work with the basic curve that we had. You can work with the location of the points on the ground so they can kind of not be parallel. And you can come up with very different ideas. You can come up with very different products at the end. How about I just group this and make here a little bit organized? The first group is about the points. Then I created the basic curve. So this is the group related to our basic curve. These set of nodes are our multiple curves. So I'm going to put curves. Or I can just put, for instance, translated curves because they have been moved in the x direction, so translated curves, and then this group is responsible for our final bench. So I can put the bench here. So to go over what we did is we created some points. We made a curve out of the points. We moved the curves in the x direction by like about 30. And if you change any of these values, the final product is going to change, right? And then we patched the curves to get the surface, and then we thickened the surface to get the final volume for the bench. Like anything else, you can just import this back to Rhino. I can type import. I would like to go by import by geometries because it's going to group all the geometries together. I can put this on manual. You can save your file. And if I go to my Revit, you see that we have the curve here. And if I go to manage, object styles, imported objects, I can assign material through this layer here.